इवेल्युएशन ऑफ रियल डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल पर आधारित प्रश्नों में से एक प्रश्न और हम आपको देते हैं जो एग्जामिनेशन में पूछा गया है, एकेटीयू के एग्जामिनेशन में, और उस प्रश्न को हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे तो आपको और आइडिया मिलेंगे जिससे कि किसी भी रियल डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल को किस तरह से हम कंटूर इंटीग्रेशन की सहायता से आसानी से हम सॉल्व करके उसके रिजल्ट की प्राप्ति कर सकते हैं। तो आइए हम बात करते हैं एक क्वेश्चन की जो कि इम्पोर्टेंट भी है और एग्जामिनेशन में पूछा गया है। अप्लाई कैलकुलस ऑफ रेजिड्यू अप्लाई कैलकुलस ऑफ रेजिड्यू टू प्रूव दैट इंटीग्रल जीरो से इंफिनिटी डीएक्स अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर होल स्क्वायर डीएक्स अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू पाई अपॉन फोर ए क्यू ए इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो पाई अपॉन फोर ए क्यू ए इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो ये क्वेश्चन है एंड टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन एंड एज पर द कैलकुलस ऑफ रेजिड्यू कंसर्न सच टाइप ऑफ इंटीग्रल रियल डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल कैन बी इवेल्युएटेड बाय चूजिंग अ फंक्शन ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स वेरिएबल एज वेल एज चूजिंग अ पाथ ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन मीनिंग देयर बाय choosing the simple closed contour so that such type of integral can be evaluated in easily manner. So now we shall try to choose the function of complex variable. So here we write the solution. To evaluate 0 से इंफिनिटी dx अपॉन x स्क्वायर प्लस a स्क्वायर होल स्क्वायर वी ट्राई टू चूज अ फंक्शन ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स वेरिएबल variable fz is equals I told you it is 1 upon z square plus a square whole square and a simple closed contour consisting of number one, minus R2 plus R on real axis. Number two, a semicircle gamma having this line having the line minus R2 plus R as a diameter. So I told you earlier, this is very important. This choice of function and the choice of contour is very important when you are going to solve the real definite integral with the help of calculus of rigidity. Now you have taken the function fx, fz is equals 1 upon z square plus e square whole square as per given real definite integral. So we first try to find the poles of this fz and then after we will try to find the pole which lies inside the contour you have taken, and then after you use a residue theorem to evaluate such type of integral, and then it becomes easy. So here we find,
sir.
Yes.
Sir, Akash ko in kar lijiye.
Kar liya, beta. We find the poles of FZ. Poles of FZ are z square plus a square whole square is equals zero. You know, z square plus a square whole square is equals zero gives z is equals plus minus I times a twice. दो बार देता है, यानी कि z is equal to plus I is again two times, z equals minus I times a is again two times. So you can say here the poles of FZ are z is equals plus I of order 2, as well as z is equals minus I times a of order 2. So here, that is z is equals plus times I times a, and z is equals minus I times a are the poles of FZ of order 2. Of order 2. अब आपको ये, you should try to find which pole is just going to lie inside the contour you have taken. So I'm going to draw here. Here is y axis. You know, it is y axis, horizontal line, and it is named here imaginary axis. And you draw a horizontal line, you know, intersecting this vertical line, and this is called x-axis. Of course, in this case, it is real axis. And this point of intersection of these two lines, horizontal and vertical, is called origin. You know, origin is 0, 0. And here we mark minus r, and here we mark a plus r. And then we draw a circle, semicircle, of course, like this. It is a semicircle, and this semicircle is a gamma. So here we find minus r to plus r, and here is gamma, is described in anti-clockwise direction, and these two, gamma and minus r to plus r, is just going to be a closed contour, and named it is C. This is the closed contour. When we look at the poles, z is equals minus I times a, it is not lie in the contour taken, whereas z is equals plus I times a lie inside the contour taken. So here we can say right here, z is equals plus minus plus I times a is a pole of FZ of order 2. Of order 2, which lies inside C. Thus, residue of FZ at Z is equals plus I times a pole of order. A pole of order 2 is equal to limit z is tending to plus time I times a 1 upon factorial 2 minus 1. किसी का माइक्रोफोन ऑन है, जरा उसको निवेदन है कि वो बंद कर ले. D to the power 2 minus 1 upon d to z to the power 2 minus 1, you know, and it is z plus I times a whole square into E of z. This is the way to find the residue of the function at the double pole. अगर आप ये खत्म हो गया तो मैं मिटाऊं ऊपर से. हेलो, सो नाउ यू फाइंड हियर रेजिड्यू इज नाउ नथिंग, इट इज लिमिट जेड इज टेंडिंग टू प्लस आई टाइम्स ए d upon dz, because 1 by factorial 1 is 1, and here is z plus I times a whole square, fz means 1 upon z square plus a square whole square, and again this can be written as limit z is tending to plus I times a, and here a minus, it is minus, of course it is minus, because z is tending to a plus I times a. So here d upon dz is now equal to this d by dz into, and here is z minus I times a whole square 1 upon z minus I times a whole square and z plus I times a whole square. This can be written just by making a linear factor of z square plus a square. So you can, z square plus a square can be broken into two linear factors. One of them is z minus I times a, and other is z plus I times a. And it is a whole square, so this product will be whole square. So here z minus I times a whole square and z plus I times a whole square. This z minus I times a whole square and this z minus I times whole square is cancelled out. And now the limit of this is limit z is tending to plus I times a and d upon dz. You know, it is z plus I times a to the power minus 2. And you can differentiate with the help of, with the respect to z. And then after you put the limit, here z is equals plus I times a. When we differentiate, this is minus 2 and z plus I times a to the power minus 3. And when we take a limit of z is equal to I times a, you will find here minus 2. And here is 2 I times a to the power minus 3. Finally, you have minus 2 upon, and here is 2 to the 4 to the 8. So it is minus 8 I times A. You know, I square is minus 1 and then I, so it is minus 1. So we can say here 2 upon 8 I times A. This is the A cube, 8 I times A cube. This is the residue of the function. At the given pole, z is equals plus I times a, which is a pole of order 2 of the given function. Now the we shall use a residue theorem, and then after we proceed by residue theorem we have integral c f of z dz is equals 2 pi I times sum of residues of fz at the poles lies inside C. You know, it is a residue theorem. So here we can say integral c f of z is nothing but it is 1 upon z square plus a square whole square dz, and this is nothing but is 2 pi I, and here is sum of residues, is only one residue, 2 upon 8 and I times a cube. I has cancelled, 2 to the 4 to the 8. So we can say here pi upon 2a cube is the residue of the function. By residue theorem, you have get this value is 2 pi, pi upon 2a cube. Now, when we see that, we find here integral c f of z dz can be written as integral minus r to plus r, you know, it is f of z dz, and here is plus gamma f of z dz, and so integral c f of z dz means integral c 1 upon z square plus a square whole square dz, you know, and this is equals minus r to plus r. When you travel on minus r to plus r, y becomes 0. So it is 1 upon x square plus a square whole square dx, you know, and this is nothing but it is gamma. And here is 1 upon z square plus a square whole square dz. So when we find the value of this on the right, left hand side, you have got the value of this integral with the help of residue theorem. It is pi upon 2a cube. So you can write here pi upon 2a cube, and here is minus r to plus r, and 1 upon x square plus a square whole square dx, you know, and here is gamma 1 upon z square plus a square whole square dz, right? Now we have to find, you have to take this r, you have taken the contour c of semicircle of diameter having minus r to plus r. So when r may be taken as large as you can, so I'm just taking here r is tending to infinity, so taking limit r is tending to infinity, we get, so what will happen when we take this limit r is tending to infinity, in this situation you will find here pi upon 2a cube, all right, and here is limit r is tending to infinity minus r to plus r, you know, and it is 1 upon x square plus a square whole square dx, and plus here is limit r is tending to infinity integral gamma, and it is dz upon z square plus a square whole square. Now we have to calculate the value of second integral on the right hand side by taking use of Jordan lemma, you know, Jordan lemma. So by using Jordan lemma, the second integral on the right hand side vanishes, that is limit r is tending to infinity gamma dz upon z square plus a square whole square is equal to 0. Then above equation reduces to, then above equation reduces to, it is pi upon 2a cube, all right, and here is minus infinite to plus infinite 1 upon x square plus a square whole square dx, and next one is 0. And you know, इंटीग्रल माइनस ए टू प्लस ए यू नो एफ एक्स डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू टू टाइम्स ऑफ जीरो टू ए एफ एक्स डी एक्स यू नो इट इज ओनली पॉसिबल इफ यू एफ ऑफ माइनस एक्स इज इक्वल्स एफ एक्स इट इज इवन फंक्शन यू नो इवन फंक्शन अदरवाइज इट इज जीरो इफ एफ एक्स ऑफ माइनस एक्स इज इक्वल्स माइनस एफ एक्स इज ऑड फंक्शन ऑड फंक्शन with the help of this property you will find the first integral on the right hand side is 2 times 0 to infinite so here is pi upon 2a cube and here is 2 times 0 say infinite dx upon x square plus a square whole square and this gives finally and this gives integral 0 to infinity dx upon x square plus a square whole square is nothing but it is pi upon 4a cube and this is the required result. So in this way you can find the value of the real definite integral and this is the way and you can do on the same pattern. There are several questions given in your book. You try to find the solution and if you feel any difficulties please call me otherwise I hope you will do all these questions. Now I am taking another example. There are so many examples, but I am taking another example which has been taken in university examination, AKTU examination 2017. So I am taking this to consider. This question is asked in our AKTU examination. In 2017, integral evaluate by using contour integration. Evaluate the integral. Integral by using contour integration. Contour integration, it is integral minus infinite to plus infinite cos x upon minus infinite to plus infinite cos x upon x square plus a square x square plus b square dx where a is greater than b is greater than 0 where a is greater than b and greater than 0 and here you shall discuss this has been taken into examination AKTU 2017 so today we will discuss this example this question look at the choice of the function first here let fz is how much you know I told you maine baat aapko bataya tha ki when you want to choose a function and this if this real definite integral involves sin x and cos x you would like to choose e to the power z e to the power iz you know so here I am taking here function is e to the power I times z upon here is z square plus a square and z square plus b square just I have taken I times z and then after you try to find the poles of this function and contour is taken here y axis is just taken here imaginary axis imaginary axis, you know, and here is the real axis. And here is a semicircle minus R to plus R, and the contour consisting of a line minus R to plus R and a semicircle gamma having this line as a diameter. This is gamma and this is now closed. So I have taken here as closed contour, and we choose a simple closed contour C consisting of a line minus R to plus R, you know, on real axis, and number two, a semicircle gamma having above line as a diameter, above line minus R to plus R as diameter. Then what should we try to find? We should find the poles of this abjad. First, the poles of abjad is z square plus a square, z square plus b square is equals 0. And so we can say here z square is equals minus a square and z square is equals minus b square, and we can say here z is equals plus minus I times a, and another is here z is equals plus minus I times b. These are the simple poles of this function. Z is equals plus I times a and z is equals minus I times a are the simple poles of this function. But only the pole z is equals plus I times a lies inside the C, whereas z is equals plus b I times b lies inside C, and other poles z is equals minus I times a and z is equals minus I times b does not lie in the given in the closed contour C taken by you. So here you write the poles z is equals plus I times a and z is equals plus I times b, simple poles lies inside C. Thus the residue of abjad at z is equals plus I times a is R1. I have taken R1, and this R1 is limit z is tending to I times a, z minus I times a fz. Fz means 1 upon z square plus a square and z square minus plus b square. When we calculate this limit z is tending to I times a, and here is z minus I times a, and here is z square z plus I minus I times a and z plus I times a, and another is z square plus b square. Z minus I times a, z minus I times a has cancelled. When we put the value of z as equal to I times a, we will find here 1 upon 2 I times a. And here is b square minus a square. This is the residue of abjad at z.